manager asked if there's a bunch of empty spaces in the middle that you could squeeze in a little bit so other people could get a chair. Mm-hmm. So in the middle rows, it looks like we've got some empty spots. If you could squeeze in a little bit, that would help other people get a chair. Thank you. today. We hope you had a great time, and we're ready for the last band of the day. But before we do that, I want to introduce you to one of the most amazing people, and our district is very, very successful and very happy to have this person leading us, and I'd like to introduce you to the chancellor of the district for City College District, and this is Dr. Esau Colbert.
Compared to everything that we do here in Riverside Community College District, other than the graduation, this is probably one of the most momentous events. And it is, we are all thrilled to welcome all our esteemed guests to the 2023 Riverside City College Jazz Festival. I'm sure you've been going through here, and so you prepare to be captivated by exceptional lineup of performances featuring the middle schools, high schools, colleges, guest artists, and incredibly talented students and faculty of Riverside City College. I want to take a moment to express our immense pride in the students who will be performing tonight. Their hard work and dedication to their craft has been nothing short of remarkable. And we are honored to have them grace our stage. This is a wonderful facility, as you all have witnessed. I'm not going to tell you how much that costed us, but it is second to Disney. So now you can see that we have the best, you know, designers in acoustics that have prepared this. But buildings are only buildings. They become momentous, they become centers of excellence when we attract the talents that you've seen today and you will see tonight. And so we're very grateful and honored to have all of you here. We also want to extend our heartfelt gratitude to the faculty and employees who have tirelessly supported and nurtured these students. Students in middle school, in high school, in colleges, everywhere, all teachers. This is a Teachers Week. I want to honor all of them for their hard work, as well as all the individuals who helped and make tonight's event possible. Let's give them a big hand. Music and performing arts programs are unmatched in their dedication to musical excellence, and we couldn't be prouder. Thanks to the Henry Coyle Senior and Alice Edna Coyle School for the Arts, which is this building here, this facility, Riverside Community College District music programs are experiencing unprecedented growth and interest, opening up new and exciting opportunities for partnering with world-class artists in the concert hall. And that's why we are able to give education of the highest possible quality. We extend a warm and heartfelt welcome to all our attendees, to all of you, and we hope that you will experience at the RCC Jazz Festival will be nothing short of unforgettable. Welcome again and thank you. Thank you.
So this is one of seven big bands we have at RCC. We have four that meet during the day with full-time students, and then we have three evening bands that Monday evening group is this one, and then we have a Tuesday evening and Thursday evening, and these are folks who are like local band directors and players who just want to keep their chops up, or faculty in many cases up here. And so that's why the ages of all the different bands look a little different. So we get together on Monday nights once a week, and we have a good time, rehearse a little bit, and we'd like to share some music with you tonight. First thing I'd like to do is Easy to Love. It's Cannibal Adderley's solo written out for the sax section.
Thank you.
session. The next thing we'd like to do for you is written by our pianist, who's a fabulous composer arranger, and we've been playing his music for years, and we're very, very fortunate to have such a resource here. He teaches for us here at the college, and he formerly was an arranger for the Marines, and now we're glad to have him in our community writing for us. And for those of you who enjoyed sight reading, he was the person who wrote those tunes and got to do that, so how about a hand for Sandy Mavis? And this, he's written an arrangement that's going to feature Danny Valencio on the trombone and Gary Wilson on the baritone sax, and this is The Preacher.
Thank you.
Sandy's arrangements. Now we'd like to do an original composition of his. Give you an idea of how prolific he is. He usually brings one of these in every Monday. And this is called Will Be That Was.
Thank you.
Chris Paris on the trumpet. The composer, Sammy Nagin. It's the third or fourth time we played that. So the sight reading thing is a big deal. So if you'd like to play more music, better sight reading, more music you can play, and better music, and you can play in better groups. So we encourage sight reading a great deal, as you might have figured out. So this time, I'd like to bring out the gentleman who's just been stunning and dazzling everybody for a couple days, and he has just been an awesome human being to work with. He's been just really, really inspirational to watch and listen to, and I think you're going to be amazed. Please welcome John DeVerse. Hey, you're fun, thank you. Give yourselves a hand, you're fun. If you'll allow me, I just want to take a moment here to share with you some deep gratitude, just to be able to share these last 2 days with this beautiful community. I have the opportunity, the privilege to travel all over the place and play music and get to play with different folks and meet new people, new communities. And I can always sense the vibe. And it's different everywhere. And the commitment to community here, the commitment to great music, the community, the commitment to sharing this throughout the community is at a high. And I hope that, especially for the younger folks here, that you understand that this place, this community, all the high schools, all the people that you're meeting, all the people that you're rubbing shoulders with, it doesn't happen everywhere. That this kind of support and this kind of strength and nurturing and challenging and pushing us to be our best, it doesn't happen everywhere. So embrace that and cherish it and appreciate it. So I want to thank everybody here at RCC, Charlie and Richard, for putting this event on. You can clap for him. We're going to do that one more time because there are like 90 bands that came in here. And this, can you imagine the organization that it takes to do all of this and all the volunteers, all the faculty, all the staff, all the deans, the provost, the president, to put all of this on in this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful theater. So we're going to try that one more time. Here's thanks to everyone here at RCC, including Charlie Richards. Behind me right here.
first tune is called Don't Jive the Hitman. You want to know the story?
Yes.
Okay. It's not something I'm very proud of. It was a long time ago. Back in the day when I had brown hair. You know, a friend of mine came over to my studio apartment, and he was a viola player, and he had played a wedding with a string quartet. And he said, "John, you know, we played this wedding, and they didn't pay us. I didn't get paid for it. I don't know what to do." And I just thought that was terrible. And I said, "You know what? I've got the afternoon free. Let's go take care of it." And so I used to wear cowboy boots a lot. I had black boots. I put them on. I put on kind of all black, a nice little blazer, black shirt. And also was studying to play the cello at that point. So I had a cello there. So I put the cello in the case, and I said, "Let's get in the truck, let's go find this guy." And so we went, and I met the person, and we said, "We need to collect the money now." I didn't say that, my friend said that. I just stood in the back of my cello case like this. And then he got in the truck with us, and we went to, 147,000 ATMs, and there was no money coming out of those ATMs. And then we went to his cousin's house, and we went to his friend's house. Turned out nobody wanted to give him the money to pay for the wedding. And every time we would get out, I would come out, and I would have the cello case right behind him. And I remember he turned to my friend, he said, "And my friend said, he doesn't like to talk about it." And I did not crack a smile the whole time. It was really bad. Don't ever do this. Don't ever do this. So like 5 hours later, we finally found a friend of his that actually loaned him the money and paid my friend. And then I went home and I wrote this song. Thank you. number two. We're gonna play an arrangement of mine, of a Cole Porter song, an unlikely Cole Porter song. It's an old cowboy song. I'm from LA, but we moved to a small little town. Grew up in a small little town in Oklahoma, Ada. Well, we moved there when I was about seven. We lived there from when I was 7 to 14, so sometimes people ask me, what the hell is your accent? So it's some sort of combination of a lot of things. But I like cowboys, I like cowboy songs, I like freedom. I like love, and I like freedom. And when we put those two things together, really beautiful things happen. And this is an arrangement that was on a record that I made called American Dreamers. And it's about those things. It's about love and freedom. And it's even got a free jazz moment in this arrangement for that reason. And some call and response until we all come together in unity again. This is Don't Fence Me.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being a great audience.